solving the cosmological constant problem based on the duality of time theory. In this video, we want to see how the duality of time theory provides a simple solution to the huge value of the zero-point energy suggested by quantum field theory, and reconcile it with the value of dark energy that has been experimentally estimated in 1998, as well as explaining the source of dark matter and dark energy and their structure and relation to normal baryonic matter. The duality of time postulate states that, at every instance of the outward normal level of time, space and matter are perpetually being recreated in one linear chronological sequence which forms the inward levels of time that are also nested inside each lower dimension of space. This means that at every instance of the real flow of time there is only one metaphysical point, that is the unit of space-time geometry, and the universe is a result of its perpetual recurrence in the inner levels of time, which is continuously and perpetually recreating the dimensions of space and what it may contain of matter particles, which then kinetically evolve throughout the outer normal level of time that we encounter. This geometrical point is the single monad that has been explained in the first volume of this series. In the 14th century, the Catholic Church decided to adopt the Aristotelian static and geocentric model of the universe, and it considered scientists who criticized this model as heretics. In The Brief History of Time, Stephen Hawking says, "Even Einstein, when he formulated the general theory of relativity in 1915, was so sure that the universe had to be static that he modified his theory to make this possible, introducing a so-called cosmological constant into his equations." Einstein added the cosmological constant to his field equations so that the positive attraction of matter may balance the cosmological constant repulsion. However, after Hubble's discovery of the expansion of the universe in 1929, he abandoned this idea and called it his biggest blunder. However, again, in 1998, after the discovery of the accelerating universe from distant type 1A supernovae, in addition to the data from the cosmic microwave background and large galaxy redshift surveys, astronomers were able to measure the evolution of the expansion rate of the universe, and found it to be accelerating, which led to the current standard model of cosmology, the lambda cold dark matter model. On the other hand, as early as 1960s, quantum field theory predicted that quantum fluctuations would make huge contributions to the vacuum energy, much larger than the energy due to the cosmological constant, which was known to be either zero or very small. The problem became extremely critical after the development of inflationary models in the 1980s, since the cosmic inflation is driven by vacuum energy and even the smallest changes in its value will lead to different expansion scenarios. As Steven Weinberg showed, there are many problems associated with the cosmological constant. The observed acceleration of the expansion simply means that the cosmological constant is about 120 orders of magnitude smaller than the density of vacuum energy, or the Planck density, that can be calculated from quantum field theory. This is known as the problem of smallness. Moreover, being so small, why it just happens to have exactly the value that makes its density similar to the average matter density, which is called the coincidence problem. Many solutions have been suggested, but because the discrepancy is so huge, none of the speculations came ever close to solving the puzzle, which indicates that there is something substantially wrong in our understanding of quantum physical processes. Therefore, this problem was described as the worst theoretical prediction in the history of physics. In the duality of time theory, the huge discrepancy in the cosmological constant problem is diminished and even eliminated because of the chronological recreation of space in the inner levels of time. Therefore, the vacuum energy should be calculated from the average of all states, and not the collective summation as it is currently treated in quantum field theory. This means that we should divide the vacuum energy density by the number of modes included in the unit volume, which is in the order of 117, because we divide by Planck length cube, since the cutoff is applied at the Planck scale. This will reduce the discrepancy between the observed and the predicted vacuum energy density from 120 into only 3 orders of magnitudes. The remaining very small discrepancy could be explained according to quintessence models. But a more accurate calculation is needed first because all the current methods are approximate. Moreover, because of the genuinely complex nature of time, the two primordial states of void and vacuum are multiplied into 4 elemental states, which are nothing but the 4 classical elements of the Sumerians: earth, fire, water and air. These are the 4 extreme states in nature, where earth is absolute mass, fire is absolute energy, air is the supergas, 0, C, and water is the superfluid, C. 0, that corresponds to Bose-Einstein condensate, while normal baryonic matter is simply when this ground state is excited into C, V, and antimatter is the excitation of the supergas into V, C. Dark matter and dark energy are the other possible states, which also include the states formed from the conjugate time directions. These states of matter and energy are dark because they do not interact with the baryonic matter, since they exist on orthogonal dimensions. It is also clear from this diagram how this model could explain supersymmetry and matter-antimatter asymmetry.
إياك يا